morning. In the last lecture, we have discussed about what is exact straight line mechanism and what is approximate straight line mechanism and how a pantograph works. And of course, we have also discussed pasular mechanism. Okay, so let me first brief in 2 minutes what is exact straight line, approximate straight line and pantograph. Then I will go for today's lecture, that is exact straight line mechanisms. Under that we will cover 3 different mechanisms. Okay, so let us see first what is exact straight line mechanism, what is approximate straight line mechanism. In real applications, we need certain occasions the motion of one of the link should be perfectly a horizontal or a vertical, or it is a straight line requirement is there. So in those cases, we design the mechanism such a way that whatever the input link, it rotates or oscillates or whatever it may be, one of the output link will give an exact straight line motion. And whereas in some cases it may not be possible to obtain exact straight line, but approximately closer to a straight line can be obtained for either small movement of inputs or large movement of inputs. Depends upon the requirement and the application point of view. Then we have discussed about a Davis, that is a pantograph mechanism, where you can enlarge or you can reduce a size of the component or a drawing of the component by just copying. It is a copying mechanism. So for that, I have given an example, like you have a small component, okay, and you have to amplify this in a drawing with a bigger size, or vice versa, you have a bigger component and its miniature is required in the drawing, then how to copy that? With the help of this pantograph mechanism, we have seen, so we can enlarge or we can reduce by mechanical mode. Okay, and we have also discussed the one of the mechanism, that is exact straight line mechanism, pasular mechanism. Okay, so today's lecture I will start once again from the pasular mechanism, because under this particular lecture it takes care about all the 3 mechanisms which we have in our syllabus. That is, one is pasular mechanism, another one is a Hart, and last one is a Scott-Russell mechanism, isn't it? So here I have shown in the animation, the animations are showing these mechanisms. The first one is a pasular mechanism and the second one is Hart mechanism. This is the Hart mechanism, and the third one is a Scott-Russell mechanism. So out of these 3 mechanisms, the Scott-Russell mechanism is a very simple mechanism. So it's as simple as like your single slider crank chain mechanism, nothing else, nothing else. It is as good as same. Only the thing is the connecting rod is extended, and the connecting rod extended point tracing the straight line motion. Okay, that is the only, the last mechanism under this heading, Scott-Russell, is very simple. But of course it will have its own limitation. What is that limitation? That we will see when we discuss it. So here the diagrams are shown such a way that, so same colors are used, wherever the lengths are equal. If you look at here, the first one, that is in the pasular mechanism, so I have distinguished them by 3 different colors: green, blue, red. So green, blue, red, that means these 2 green color indicating these 2 links are equal in lengths, and these 4 links are shown with a red color, that is these 4 links are with equal size. Then here you can observe one blue color solid line and one blue color dotted line. That is, One is a fixed link and another one is a movable link. Both are same color indicated. That means they are same in size. Okay, that is in the first case. So you can see here total how many links are there. So there is one fixed link and another one under blue color movable link 2 plus green 2, 4, and you have 4 red color links. That means totally 8 links are available under this mechanism, that is a passular mechanism. So the second one here, let us see, that is a heart mechanism. So you can also observe here, two links are shown with a red blue color, two links are shown with blue, and two links are shown with white color. So you can observe here this point, whereas the path traced on this is not a separate link, it is a part of that link, because you can observe here there is no relative motion in this link. So it is only joining this link and this link, and the point on this middle link is indicating its output as a straight line. Of course, this is a fixed link, this white link is a fixed link, and this red link, you can see, this is with a pivot point of here, it is oscillating. Okay, so here how many links you can observe totally. So one is fixed link, one movable link, two white links, and two blue links, and two red links. 6 links you can see. And then finally here you can see there is one fixed link, one slider, and one blue link which is a connecting rod, and a red one which is like a crank. So there are total 4 links. Here you can see 4 links, here you can see 6 links, and whereas in this mechanism you can see there are total 8 links. So in all these cases, the output which we are obtaining is a straight motion. You can see here it's a vertical path, and here also you can observe there is a vertical path, and here also you can see there is a vertical path. So this is the vertical path. So all these 3 cases you can observe the mechanisms which are giving a straight line motion. We'll see one by one. So let us first see the first mechanism, passular mechanism. So here, just now I told the mechanism, you can observe with the total links of 8 in number, and these 2 links are blue in color with a equal size, and the 2 links with a green color which is equal in size, and the remaining 4 links which are red in nature, they are equal in size, total 8 links, and this is the fixed link. So for them I have given some naming here, like O1. So the fixed link is called O1, and the crank like O1A. Okay, and you can see O1 is equal to O1A, and OC is equal to OD, and then AC is equal to CB, and that is equal to BD is equal to AD. Okay, so the mathematical proof is given here. So the same what I have shown there, I have kept in the animation here, and I put the diagram at the top. Let us see for the mathematical thing. So whatever I have explained, I have everything I have made in statements here. See, it consists of a fixed link O1 and other straight link, that is O1A, this is the O1A, and OC and OD, then AD, DB, CB and CA are the connected by turning pairs. You can observe here all the pairs in this mechanism are turning pairs. This is a turning pair, this is a turning pair, here you have a turning pair,
all are having turning pace. It is completely mechanism formed by turning pace. So you can also observe that is AC is equal to CB is equal to AD is equal to DA. This is the statement. Then OC is equal to OD. So that is OC is equal to OD. So OC is equal to OD. So OC then OD. Okay, then what other things we can observe from here? OO1 is equal to O1A. So OO1 is equal to O1A. So that is the basic construction of the mechanism. Then here we can prove that OA into OB is remains constant when the link O1A rotates. So for that, what is the analysis we'll make? Let us see. So we can join C and D, okay, and which will bisect the A and B at R. So C and D is joined, okay, imaginary, and then it bisects the AB at a point R. So from simple right angle triangles, we can write in ORC and BRC. So what is ORC? This is ORC, this triangle. This is the ORC triangle. So in this ORC triangle, this is the right angle triangle. We can write OC square is equal to OR square plus RC square. So similar, the other triangle, that is BRC. What is BRC? This is the triangle BRC. So BRC. So we can write BC square is equal to BR square plus CR square. So that is what we have written here, the two equations. This is say equation number one and this is equation number two. So from this geometry, I have written these equations. OC square is equal to OR square plus RC square, and BC square is equal to RB square plus RC square. So what I did, I simply subtracted equation 1 and 2. That is OC square minus BC square is nothing but RC square can get cancelled, OR square minus RB square. Then this is A square minus B square. This can be written as A plus B into A minus B. That is OR plus RB into OR minus RB. Okay. So let us see the diagram. What is OR plus RB? So this is OR and this is RB. So this is simply nothing but OB. Then the other one, OR minus RB. Because we know RB is equal to RA. So OR minus OB will give you OA. So that is OB into OA, OB into OA. So on the left hand side, what we have, that is OC and BC. So what is OC? OC is the length of the link. And what is BC? BC is also length of the link. So whatever the position of the mechanism, it takes a turn. It doesn't matter, the difference of OC square and BC square will not change, because this is a fixed part. This is also fixed part. So when they are fixed part, whatever the movement of the crank or the input link that it moves, it will not change the difference of OC square and BC square. Then the left hand side is constant, means automatically it is right hand side is also constant. That means OB into OA is a constant.
So in the last lecture we have discussed to get exact straight line mechanism, the necessary condition is that is OA into OB should be a constant. OA into OB should be a constant. So that's why you can get the output in a vertical or in an exact straight line motion. You can see here whatever we are proving in the mathematical mode above, that you can observe here by the animation. So whatever the rotation of my link O1A and whatever the moment of my link OC and OD, but the point B is always moving on a straight line. The point B moves on a straight line, isn't it? So this is what the first mechanism, exact straight line mechanism, Tassilar mechanism. So the same thing which I have explained is written in the statement here. Since OC and BC are of constant length, okay, therefore the product of OB into OA is remains constant. Hence the point B traces a straight line perpendicular to the diameter OP. That is what you can observe. So this is the OP. So this diameter, okay, extended this, this gives a horizontal line perpendicular to this, the B will be moving up and down. That is what you can observe here. This is the first mechanism, fascicular mechanism, which consists of the total links are 8, one fixed link which is OO1 which is equal to O1A, and the two other links equal are like AC, CB, BD, DA, and finally that OC is equal to OD. So this is the first mechanism, fascicular mechanism. Now let us see the second mechanism, Hart's mechanism. The same thing here we have given with the naming and other things, the animation first you observe what it is happening, then we can prove here. So the exactly the same thing you can observe here in the diagram, or in the next diagram I will show you. The same diagram is given with a bigger size. First observe the animation. Here two links with white color, two links with a red color, and two links with a blue color. But don't take this point as like link here and here. This is a single link. You can observe here with this pivot point, this link is oscillating. Similarly, you can observe this is a point. This is a point on that link. There is no relative motion on the blue link. So hence the total number of links you can observe here. Observe this. This is 1, this is 2, and this is 3, and this is 4, and 5, and 6. There are total 6 links are there. Okay. So let us see what are those. So now I made the animation in a smaller size, and I made this the geometry which I require is in a bigger size. So you can observe here same thing. O1 is a fixed link, then O1A, then FC. Let me put number 1. So then O1A, 2, then FC, 3, then CD, 4, then DE. So where is the DE? This DE, 5. Then finally EF. Total 6 links are there. All are turning pairs. A turning pair. So a turning pair. So turning pair. Turning pair. Turning pair. Turning pair. All are turning pairs. Isn't it? So here we can observe the equality of the links.
FC and DE are equal in length. FC, that is, this is DE, okay, which is equal to FC. Okay, and similar, CD and EF are equal. So CD, CD and EF are equal. So I have made it two lines here that indicates both are same. Three lines here, both are same, isn't it? And you can see here points O, that is O, A and B. O, A and B. So that divides the link such a way that FC and CD and EF in the same ratio, that is the necessary condition. So that is the important thing. O, A, B, that is O, which divides in the FC, okay, and A, that is which divides CD, and then B, which divides the link EF, such a way that the ratios are same, okay. And as we have seen in the last mechanism also, our objective is to make OA into OB is a constant. So from the similar triangles of CFE and OFB, CFE and OFB, so that is C, CFE okay and OFB, this is O F O F B. So O F B, so O F, this is the point B. So these two triangles are similar. I have shown one is with green color and another one is with a yellow color. These two are similar. So from the similar triangles, we can write the relation CE by FC is equal to OB by OF. So just cross multiplication, we can write OB is equal to CE into OF by FC. So OB is equal to CE into OF by FC. So similar from the another two similar triangles, FCD and OCA. So from the another two similar triangles, FCD and OCA, we can also write the relation FD by FC is equal to OE by OC. Then there, by cross multiply, by separating it OA, OA can be written as FD OC by FC. Now, the left hand side of the previous part OB and this part of OA. So OA into OB, the left hand side parts are multiplied, then the right hand side parts, that is FD into OC by FC into CE into OF by OFC. So FC square, then FD into CE into OC into OF, isn't it? So you can see here, what is OC, OF, FC square? OC, you can see OC and OF, OC, OF, where is OF? This, okay, and FC, that is FC. So here, these are all fixed. This is the lengths of the link OC, OF, FC. OC, OF, FC are all lengths of the link which are fixed irrespective of the mechanism position. So when they are fixed, then the product is a constant. So if this is a constant, okay, So OA into OB is a product into constant. OA into OB is a product into constant. So what is FD into CE? FD and CE both are not the links. Okay, but what is OA OB? So OA and OB, so they are also not the links. OA, okay, as well as OB. So where is the B point? OA and OB. So they are also not the actually the length of the links, but this can be possible only if there is a constant here, and if this should be a constant means this is also should be a constant. So that can be proved by like this. So from the point E, so draw EM, that is EM, which is parallel to, CF. So at point E, draw a line parallel to ECF, which is called EM, and draw a line EN perpendicular to MO. Then you get triangles of EMN and ENO. Okay, so here I can write FD into